A little over a week after signing the Bangsamoro Organic Law, President Duterte led a ceremony in Malacañang to mark the passage of the landmark legislation.
10 days ago, I signed into law the Organic Law for Bangsamoro Region for Muslim Mindanao, which I hope will finally end the decades of conflict that is rooted in the Bangsamoro's fight for self-determination and recognition of their unique identity.
The Bangsamoro Autonomous Region will have its own parliament and will automatically receive 60 billion pesos in a yearly block grant from the national government. It will have control over its natural resources and will enforce the Sharia law in all aspects of the lives of Muslims. The new region hopes to expand the existing 5 provinces of the ARMM to also include Isabela City in Basilan, 6 towns in Lanao del Norte, and 39 villages in North Cotabato. But first, the MILF will need the consent of affected residents in a plebiscite. Bangsamoro Transition Commission Chairman Ghazali Jaffer said they are willing to discuss the measure with those who have different opinions and interpretation of the law. The BTC admits they need to do more to inform the people about the benefits of the law.
Willing kaming makipag-usap sa kung sino man yung may kanya-kanyang opinion o paniniwala para masita dito.
UP Institute of Islamic Studies Professor Julkipli Wadi says the MILF faces a tremendous challenge in showing its capability to run a government with the looming implementation of the Bangsamoro Organic Law. Wadi says the entire MILF must have a major shift of psychology from rebel group to being a new player in Philippine politics.
I think there are no substantial provisions that protects the identity or the rights of the Moro Islamic Liberation Front. But I think psychologically, the intent is really integrate or mainstream the Moro Islamic Liberation Front, efface or erase its revolutionary character. Mm. In fact, willingly, the MILF would be transformed, according to Iqbal and few others, into a social movement. Yeah. And they have to form a political party. That means, and that's precisely under the pressure.
Cotabato City is one of the areas included in the proposed Bangsamoro territory. Mayor Cynthia Gyani has been very vocal on her stand, saying it's up to the people to decide.
For the past years, we have endured the fact na hindi part ng Cotabato City ang ARMM. Kinaya natin, bumangon ang Cotabato City.
Soraida Malibo is a resident of Simway Village in Sultan Kudarat Town in Maguindanao, an MILF supporter. She's looking forward to what the Bangsamoro government will offer to Muslims.
So talagang napakasaya ko na yung BOL, Bangsamoro Organic Law na napirmahan na. Edukasyon lang una, pangalawa yung pagsakit, maraming nagasakit sa mga tao. So pero na walang pera.
Now that the law has been signed, the remaining days will be more crucial as everyone will have their say on the ratification of the law. MILF combatants will also have to register with the COMELEC for the plebiscite. Lori May Andong, ABS-CBN News. A little over a week after signing the Bangsamoro Organic Law, President Duterte led a ceremony in Malacañang to mark the passage of the landmark legislation.
10 days ago, I signed into law the Organic Law for Bangsamoro Region for Muslim Mindanao, which I hope will finally end the decades of conflict that is rooted in the Bangsamoro's fight for self-determination and recognition of their unique identity.
The Bangsamoro Autonomous Region will have its own parliament and will automatically receive 60 billion pesos in a yearly block grant from the national government. It will have control over its natural resources and will enforce the Sharia law in all aspects of the lives of Muslims. The new region hopes to expand the existing 5 provinces of the ARMM to also include Isabela City in Basilan, 6 towns in Lanao del Norte, and 39 villages in North Cotabato. But first, the MILF will need the consent of affected residents in a plebiscite. Bangsamoro Transition Commission Chairman Ghazali Jaffer said they are willing to discuss the measure with those who have different opinions and interpretation of the law. The BTC admits they need to do more to inform the people about the benefits of the law.
Willing kaming makipag-usap sa kung sino man yung may kanya-kanyang opinion o paniniwala para masita dito.
UP Institute of Islamic Studies Professor Julkipli Wadi says the MILF faces a tremendous challenge in showing its capability to run a government with the looming implementation of the Bangsamoro Organic Law. Wadi says the entire MILF must have a major shift of psychology from rebel group to being a new player in Philippine politics.
I think there are no substantial provisions that protects the identity or the rights of the Moro Islamic Liberation Front. But I think psychologically, the intent is really integrate or mainstream. The Moro Islamic Liberation Front efface or erase its revolutionary character. Mm. In fact, willingly, the MILF would be transformed, according to Iqbal and few others, into a social movement. Yeah. And they have to form a political party. That means, and that's precisely under the pressure.
Cotabato City is one of the areas included in the proposed Bangsamoro territory. Mayor Cynthia Gyani has been very vocal on her stand, saying it's up to the people to decide.
For the past years, we have endured the fact na hindi part ng Cotabato City ang ARMM. Kinaya natin, bumangon ang Cotabato City.
Soraida Malibo is a resident of Simway Village in Sultan Kudarat Town in Maguindanao, an MILF supporter. She's looking forward to what the Bangsamoro government will offer to Muslims.
So talagang napakasaya ko na yung BOL, Bangsamoro Organic Law na napirmahan at edukasyon ang una, pangalawa yung pagsakit, maraming nagasakit sa mga tao. So pero na walang pera.
Now that the law has been signed, the remaining days will be more crucial as everyone will have their say on the ratification of the law. MILF combatants will also have to register with the COMELEC for the plebiscite. Lori May Andong, ABS-CBN News.